That's how it goes.
Yay! Cheers.
Cheers.
Yeah, we can clink it there. Oh, yeah, nice. All right, Tragic Radicals. What is this podcast called?
It's called the Tragic Radicals Podcast.
Hey! Take it over. I like it.
Over.
Yeah, all right.
I like that.
That's easy.
Already.
Yeah, good. Makes my work easier.
Well, here we are. It's episode 191 of Consistently Off.
Consistently Off.
And we are here with the Tragic Radicals. Thanks for being here. Thanks for coming. Thanks for being on. When is the last time we saw either of you?
I don't think you've ever seen him.
Oh. Yeah.
The last time I saw you guys was at the Doll Hut.
That's what it was.
And you guys opened for the guy that is in...
Eagles of Death Metal.
Yeah. And I wasn't very familiar with him.
Jesse
so
Hughes,
I thought you were him.
We did play well that show.
Yeah.
You really did.
We played well that show.
You really did.
But the Boots Electric.
Boots Electric.
There you go.
Which was like a whole bunch of like... James Brown covers, I think.
Just like doo-wop and funk.
Yeah, right. Well, there was Beatles in
there too.
There
was Beatles covers.
And Fuck Boots Electric.
Whoa!
I didn't stay.
That's hard.
He was late.
You, I don't know why you didn't stay.
Because
he was an hour
show.
Late.
Because you guys killed it.
Oh.
I was also shrooming.
I heard. Boy, that was a weird. It was a weird night at the Doll Hut.
You guys sounded great.
Yeah.
Thanks.
That's a normal night at the Doll Hut.
Oh, shout out the Doll Hut. You hate it there, right?
Nick notoriously hates.
Yeah.
Nick's rage.
Yeah, yeah. But it's like the most punk rock room like there is.
At least in Southern California.
Yeah, I mean,
pretty much.
If that's how you want to put it, but it's also just a bunch of meth heads and shitbags in a dirty place that just
that's
sucks.
A
punk
most,
room. Yeah, that's
there's a little bit of that.
You're describing.
Yeah.
You're describing this thing. You're describing the thing.
Yeah.
The people are like, yes, continue.
Yeah.
Yes, yes. And there's shows.
Yeah, I guess there's too many bad
music
experiences.
Music and meth. I mean, what do you need? Great combo.
M&Ms.
What do you need?
Yeah,
good combo.
What's the best night you guys had there, like playing with? I mean, it's
with
always
and when
it's always kind of like who
we play there like once or twice a month.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah.
And we've been together for what 7 years?
7 years.
So.
Yeah.
7 years.
All right.
So we've played there a lot of times.
Nice. The best night recently was probably the Savage Magic show.
Yeah, where we ended up getting a record deal.
We did.
Ooh, that's what I'm talking about.
So that was, I guess that was pretty good.
Yeah.
I was nervous as fuck.
Cheers to that.
Yeah.
That's excellent.
Cheers.
Yeah,
cheers.
Yeah, I love
that's
that.
Cheers.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Cheers. I'm far away.
I think they need more.
Oh, I'll grab it.
They had pre-beer while we were getting technically sorted.
or a night that Whiskey Dick plays.
Oh, yeah. Have you guys heard of Whiskey Dick?
No.
I mean, as a thing,
the concept? Yes.
Yes, absolutely.
Allegedly. Yeah, yeah.
But they crush?
Oh, my
they're
God.
From,
they're excellent. They're from
Texas.
San
Antonio? Where are they
they're
from?
They're from Austin, I think.
Cool.
From Texas.
Okay.
Two-piece.
It's two guys.
Acoustic.
They both play acoustic.
And they're shredding.
And oh my God.
Like
they're
shredding harder than
any Pantera. Their self-proclaimed genre is heavy metal honky tonk.
Heavy metal honky tonk.
Oh, I like
awesome.
That.
And
that's
a
good mix.
So Hank 3?
Yes. Thank you.
Pretty much.
Yeah, cool.
Who's that two-piece from like Chicago that we played with?
The North?
Yeah.
North by North. Yeah.
You guys know that sounds familiar.
Yeah,
they're
dude,
pretty
they
cool. They constantly are on the
they
road.
They haven't stopped.
Yeah.
They play all the time.
We played with them 5 years ago, and they're just...
They're still doing
it. They just don't stop.
They're one of those
Shout
bands
out.
That's like, I'm on the road. That's where I live.
Like, I would love to have them on when they're in town, but they have to get to the next city, like, the next day.
Right.
They run it that crazy. Yeah.
That's
they are warriors.
Nice.
Yeah. Shout out to them.
Cool band.
Yeah.
North by North.
Okay, well, besides Doll Hut, what do you like in SoCal?
Yeah, Doll Hut seems like a home base, right? Kind
of.
Or...
Well, they know that they can call us a day of a show. And...
Okay.
Yeah. we've
played same day there multiple times.
Nice.
This
That's
year.
Good.
We like the Redwood. So the Redwood's good.
Yeah, Redwood Bar's
good. Redwood's fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a good punk bar.
Yeah, yeah.
We used to play the Rainbow. The Rainbow was fun.
Rainbow. Maui Sugarmill.
Maui Sugarmill's fun.
What's that?
Where's that?
Tarzana.
It's in Tarzana.
Oh.
Where's the drive, you're saying?
Oh, yes,
where Britney Spears shaved her head.
Oh, the infamous.
Viper Room is where River Phoenix died.
Yeah.
No, is where Britney shaved her head.
I like it.
I love that. Okay.
History. We got to give a shout out to Harold's.
Oh, yeah, Harold's in San Pedro. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, they're great.
I don't think we've hit San Pedro yet.
Oh, there's some good venues there now.
Sardines
good.
Yeah, okay.
We played there.
Last month or something? I don't know.
A couple months
ago.
That
whole South Bay area.
That was another...
I mean, you guys are like, we played there.
Wasn't that another last-minute show?
It was the day of. Yeah. Hours before.
Was that the day I was buying my van?
5 p.m. They're like, can you play at 8?
So
and he lives like far.
I live way out in Paris, which is in between Moreno Valley and Temecula.
Jesus. So I'm like, there's no way he's going to even be able to make
but
it there.
But she hit me up. She goes, you want to play at the Sardine? And I was like, where the fuck is that? And she goes, oh, yeah, it's in San Pedro. I was like, well, lucky for you, I'm buying a van in Santa Ana
right
now. I'm signing papers. I'll go pick up my shit and meet you there.
I'm awesome. Already in
and
Santa Ana.
We played for a total of 3 people.
Yeah.
Oh, well, your dad was there. My wife was there.
Besides,
and the other band was there.
Besides our family members and the other band, there was maybe 2 other people there.
Oh, yeah. We play lots of those.
That's a normal show for us.
We know those.
That's a normal crowd. Yeah.
That's a lot, dude. Yeah.
You get a lot of extra practice.
Wait, you got the family members too?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, my dad. And her
whatever
wife.
Reason.
Yeah.
Usually it's just the other band.
They have family members.
Allegedly.
Yeah.
Precisely.
Yeah.
Formation, right? Because I was looking, like, the first thing I found on Spotify might not be the first, like, thing you recorded, but that's 2018. So you're already on. That's already a 5-year-old record.
Yeah, but you
said
7 years. So what was that before that?
We went through.
To give you a quick snapshot of the band.
Yeah, please.
We don't know shit.
Yeah,
so give us the whole thing.
I was the
bass player. I'm the only bass player the band's ever had, and I'm also the longest sitting drummer.
Longest standing bass player,
longest
sitting drummer.
The only bass player, the only standing bass player, and the longest sitting drummer.
And I found all of you motherfuckers on
Craigslist.
Nice. All right.
Yeah.
Shout out Craigslist.
Oh, that, you know what? You're defying the odds. Together this long. Uh-huh.
Hey, after going through so many other people that we've fired or have quit.
That's what I'm saying.
Bands,
the odds.
Man.
Oh,
Bands.
We just happen to be the most insane, I guess.
Oh, yeah. So. Massachusetts, maybe.
Massachusetts.
That's what we're in for,
is
right?
East Coast masochism?
Yeah. You gotta be a little bit of masochist to live on the East Coast anyways. So.
You're goddamn right.
That's fair.
And to play music.
And just in general,
We're from Detroit.
Yeah.
Holla.
Yeah.
Holla.
Nice. Midwest is the best.
Shout
Midwest
out Detroit. It's a great
I'm from
best.
Minnesota.
Oh.
Let's go.
All right.
When'd you get out here?
2005.
Oh, fine.
Okay.
Nice.
Minnesota. Same year.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
Was that you guys are probably getting caught in the same black ice at the same time.
No shit, eh?
My car got totaled moving out here. By my drummer.
Old.
Ain't good.
Yeah. So what part of Minnesota?
Brainerd.
Brainerd.
I don't know. Sure. No idea.
Never been there.
That's where Paul Bunyan's from.
Oh.
Like, I think I...
You know him, right?
Yeah. Is there an I
it's
or
got
a Y in it?
An I.
I,
yeah.
It's brain.
Right, it looks weird. Yeah. Where is that in relation to, like, north, south, east, west of the
it's
state?
It's central.
Yeah, if you had a mitten,
central.
Where would
in
it
the middle.
Be?
Okay.
It's central, like a little bit north, but... It's mostly central,
And you had to go because you had to go, right?
Goddamn right.
Because you gotta go.
I had a lot of things going on that I was like, I gotta get the fuck out of here.
But then was it music driven?
Music driven, absolutely.
Yeah. What first instrument?
Guitar.
Oh. What age?
6.
6?
Nice.
Fantastic.
All right.
Classical?
I'm still not very good.
Well, no one's real truly
I have to ask this guy. He's got an ear. I don't have an ear. So I'm like, what's that note that I'm trying? He's like, oh, yeah, try that one. I'm like, yeah, that's the one.
Go like two frets up.
Seriously. Yeah. Like, I have to put the bass in his hands and say, show me what to do. Trying to do this. He's like, mean this?
Yeah.
That's an invaluable member.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's good chemistry.
Well, that's why she keeps me around.
First instrument.
My first instrument was the trumpet.
Trumpet.
I started playing trumpet at 9.
Okay.
For school or just?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. My elementary school had a music program.
Okay.
So I played the trumpet in 3rd grade. I moved to the saxophone 4th, 5th grades. I started playing bass in 6th grade.
Okay.
And then I played...
Like stand-up double bass or bass guitar?
Both. Okay. Yes. I started on electric bass because that's easier for a 12-year-old to be able to wrangle.
Yeah. And has frets. Yeah.
But in...
You gotta be a bass
player. Yeah. Whoa. But in middle school, I did play the upright bass starting in 8th grade all the way through for like 5 or 6 years. I played upright bass as well.
Cool. That's a hell of a thing to lug around.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then you have tuba in there somewhere.
I'm in 5th grade playing the baritone saxophone, which was about the size of me at the time.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'd roll that thing around on a dolly when I needed to go places and set it on a cardboard box to be able to play it.
Yeah,
but
the choreography just breathtaking.
Oh, no, it's excellent. It's perfect. I learned how to dance at the same time.
Yeah, you got your doo-wops down. Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, no, the bass has been the instrument I've played consistently for the longest.
Okay.
So I was the last founding member of this band. Right. She hit me up on Craigslist, like she mentioned, to come audition for the band.
Yeah.
So yeah. I showed up to the audition, and there was another guy already auditioning for the bass player.
He wasn't leaving.
Awkward. Oh.
I'm like... Weird.
It's
out
at her house.
He hung out on my front porch, like you were on the front porch. And I'm like, okay, time to
swap. Yeah,
like
he was still there when I was done. I went in and auditioned for like an hour, and this other guy was still out when we were done. I was like,
and this fool was texting me for like
weeks, months.
I'm like,
you didn't get the
gig. I'm not into your bass playing or your gender. So, try again.
He was trying to bark up the tree.
Yeah, oh, that's what it was.
All
right,
buddy.
Hilarious.
He had all the wrong signals.
Yeah. he had the self-inflicted signals.
Yeah.
He
had that's signal. Projection.
He was
friend.
Yeah. He was projecting the signals he wanted to see, and that wasn't the signals that was being.
In his mind, he's in your band and you're married, and
that was going. Yeah.
Happily ever after.
I'm gonna have to stop that right now.
Nip that in the bud.
Nip it in the bud, buddy.
So then the connection when you start jamming together, did you find like similar influences musically?
Was there a drummer yet?
We had a drummer.
Yeah, okay. We were a 4-piece band.
Okay.
We had a singer that was very good. Just very young.
Young.
Okay. Okay.
Drummer was good, not fancy, solid drummer. We were a good band. I mean, the first incarnation of the Tragic Radicals was a good band.
And our first drummer is the one that came up with the name Tragic Radicals.
Yes.
Oh, there you go. Nice.
Shout out to Nathan.
All right.
Yeah. Shout out, Nathan.
Big shout.
Yeah.
Big shout, Nate.
But, I mean, things change. And
bands.
But
he's no longer a piece of shit. Yeah.
We felt bad for him before he felt bad for himself because he had a long commute. He lived up in the high desert.
Victorville or something,
he worked
right?
up there.
Wow.
In Hesperia.
That's
he
really
lived
far.
In Hesperia, worked in Victorville, and then would just hoof it to practice every night.
Fullerton?
Yeah. And he would come early because I'd get home from work and he'd be sitting on my porch drinking a 6-pack.
I need this.
Yeah.
When we used to practice at my place.
So he did us a favor though. He let us know
eight
way
months
ahead
in
of time. Like,
he had to quit.
Okay, I know
that's
we've got
good.
Shows
that's,
booked.
Yeah.
Like I'm gonna play everything we've got on the calendar,
and then
I'm out of here.
That's
so
that's the way. If you're gonna leave a band, that's how you leave a band.
We still appreciate him to this day for that.
Yeah,
dude, crazy commute.
Yeah.
Hey, man. Yeah, he was in the band for 9 months and let us know 8 months ahead of time that he was.
So 1 month in, he knew. Yeah.
He already knew. Awesome. Yeah. He already knew. He was like, "I'm right."
And we were already booked out till October.
Yeah. 1 month in, we were already booked in Vegas. Our last show we played with him was in Vegas.
I think we played Jeff's birthday party at the world famous
Doll
Hut.
Yeah,
this was our last show.
True,
but yes, the show before that was Vegas.
It was Vegas.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's commitment. That's solid. That's good character. Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah, he was good. He was a good dude.
He was.
And then we had
a couple other drummers.
Steve 1.0.
A couple of months.
Steve 1.0.
We're going to say no. Thank you. 1.0.
Okay.
Well, and then we had Steve 2.0. Our next 2.0.
drummer was Steve 2.0. Yeah, okay. We've had two drummers named Allegedly. Steve in a row.
The first Steve just was in a mask. He was the original bass player that auditioned.
He that would make the lore way more interesting.
Right?
He kept coming back.
Yeah.
I play drums now.
So we're getting married now, right?
God. Exhausting. And then we had another singer that I had played with in a previous band.
And that came highly recommended to us from...
I vowed to never play with her again.
Uh-oh.
After the other band.
Oh, after the other band. Okay.
Yeah.
And this guy that was... He was working for Universal, I think.
Sony.
Was it? All right, I don't know.
Yeah, I'm out.
He's highly suggesting that we... offer her a position, and then we're like, oh, we'll give it a chance. Mm-hmm. Well, it wasn't too long after she came in that Steve 2.0 and her were fucking around.
Allegedly.
We were already Fleetwood Mac-ing it.
Nice.
Yeah. And I was like, oh, this is fucking bizarre. And that wasn't the problem. Like,
it's because they're doing it in front of you.
During practice.
Oh, I'm glad I didn't ever have to see that.
But it is a problem.
It's a dynamic. It's
It is a problem.
It's just going to become a problem. It isn't right now.
But they were each problems of
it
their
eventually
own.
Did become a problem. But that wasn't the main reason why either of them are no longer in the band. It just was an awkward issue.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For a while.
Yeah.
Did they leave in the same time?
No.
No.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
No, we fired Steve 2.0.
Okay.
After he pulled some selfish personal bullshit.
Allegedly.
Yeah.
Like purposefully crashed into a brick wall.
Ooh.
Whoa.
After we hanged. Like, yeah.
Yeah. Gnarly.
So we're you know, I take care of yourself.
Yeah.
Get help.
Please take care of yourself, please. Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
So that's how that went down. And then
was he still shacking up with the singer at that?
No.
At that point it was over.
No, that was pretty quick. Okay. It was a pretty quick deal. But
we had a bunch of shows booked too when that all went down. So we had played a show with a guest drummer because he was already kinda out. We played a few shows with a few different drummers. Because we played one show with Kit, we played a show with Fred.
Yeah, Fred.
One-off drummer type things.
Yeah. Big shout out to Fred. She's excellent. Well, that's what I'm getting to. So Steve was kind of on the outs. So we played a show in San Diego with our friend Kit Morris, who also recorded the first couple of our
EPs.
And then we played another show with our good friend Fred. She's a great drummer.
She's a fucking fantastic
drummer. And then I was moving to Montana.
Moving to Montana.
We played a show at the Redwood. It was our last. It was our last show.
It was a Sunday afternoon.
It was a Sunday afternoon. I brought out a bunch of my friends. We had a lot of people there for that show.
That's good.
And I played the drums at that show. Kind of last minute. We didn't have another drummer. We couldn't get anybody else to fill in. And so we were like, fuck it, I'll just play the drums, whatever. We had a donated drum kit in our studio, and we were like,
consistently
get it out of here. Wow. That's why we added testing. Yeah.
Racist.
Exactly right.
No, that was me.
All right. Oh, okay. So what?
So anyways, we had a show at the Redwood. It was my last show. I was moving. And so we didn't have a guest drummer, so we kind of went, oh, all right, I'll just play the drums. That's fine. So
Wait, so hold on. But before, we were talking about your music history, though. When did you start playing drums?
That's a good question.
That's a good question.
You're the
only
answer that.
He's like,
that day.
Yeah, I was going to say, that show? Yeah.
I got up and I started playing.
I had a passing interest in the drums. For a while,
okay, yeah,
and so I had I had a student drum kit that I had like practiced onto my bedroom, and like I'd played a little bit.
First act,
not much better than that.
Yeah,
so I'd played a little bit, and I played with just random shit.
Nice.
nothing serious at all.
I mean,
all.
Bass already gives you the rhythm, so you know, it's translation at that point.
So I didn't have a whole lot of experience playing drums, but I knew how to swing the stick and hit shit.
Yeah. Well, you used to jam. You used to do open mics when you were in Alabama, right?
That's true. I did.
Alabama? What?
Alabama. That was a long time ago. Alabama, after I graduated high school, I did 1 year of college in Alabama, then I didn't get any credits for.
Where's high school at?
Right here in Huntington Beach. I was born in Long Beach. I went to high school in Huntington Beach.
Okay.
Okay.
So
that's
I'm
where I'm at now.
California born and raised.
Yeah, fair enough.
So I
go Dodgers.
Yeah, right here. California, go Dodgers. Let's go.
What happened to our T-shirt?
The logo's on the back, anyways. It was sweaty and smelly. It was hot over there.
I took the armpits out of mine, so
well,
I'm
that's
fine.
Probably a good idea. I'll try that next time. But no, I went back to Alabama and I joined a three piece band. I was the third piece of a three-piece band, and our drummer over there was more interested in smoking weed than practicing.
Fuck yeah.
Like, smoking weed and practicing, totally acceptable. Oh, totally acceptable, but this dude would, like, fuck off practice to just hang out and get stoned when we couldn't find him, and we'd call him, and he wouldn't answer and shit, like... flaking is rough. Like, if you want to smoke weed and play drums, Doc, let's go. Pass it over, because you know we're gonna share that and have a good old time.
Right.
But we couldn't find him for days at a time. I stepped in on the drums, and we played a bunch of open mic nights. And like, I was only 19 years old. We were playing at a bar.
Nice. Yeah.
Oh, I wasn't even old enough to get in.
Wait.
Are you waiting outside and then like coming inside playing?
Oh no, they would let me in. They would let me in.
Oh, I forgot. Alabama.
It's Alabama.
Alabama.
I mean,
it's like France.
Whatever.
It's gonna be bigger than
France. Yeah. So,
he's tall enough.
So yeah, exactly.
Man-child.
Yeah, he won't get us in trouble.
So we played like every Monday night for 6 months. We'd go in there and play open mic night. We wrote some songs, and you know that bar was a piece of shit dive bar when we started.
But then you're just cutting teeth on drums all the time.
Yeah.
Oh, that's where you're learning to play
drums. That's where I'm learning how to play drums with another person.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, you know, that bar, it started with four people in there sitting at the bar, just a bunch of old crusty dudes from Alabama, and by the time we finished 6 months later, we had the place packed out.
Nice.
Sweet.
So, epic. And then I left and came back to California.
Yeah, you're like, Alabama.
Shout out
you
Alabama.
Blame me?
Okay, so then when you fill in at the Redwood, is that your permanent drummer now, or is that just like a one-time thing?
No, that was
a one-time. We thought that was a one-time thing, because I was moving to Montana.
Oh, that's right. You said Montana. Right.
Yeah, what's in Montana?
I have family up there.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
You've lived there, what, three times now?
Twice. Okay. I've lived in Montana twice.
Oh.
I lived in Montana once right before I joined the band.
Big Sky.
Yeah. I love it up there. My
beautiful country.
At the time, my girlfriend, now my wife, all her family's here. So it was a little too far away.
Got
understandable.
It. Yeah.
So I moved there once because my mom moved there, and then we moved back, and then we moved there again.
Is there like other like grandparents or something up
I've got
there?
An aunt.
Okay.
I've got an aunt and some cousins up in Montana.
Fair enough.
So we moved there.
Because otherwise it's like, Montana.
Yeah, yeah.
Dartboard.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Yeah.
I've heard it's
nice. I keep
nice.
Throwing
yeah.
it here.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The first time we moved there because my mom moved there and she needed some help.
Cool.
Yeah. And then the second time we moved there for ourselves just to kind of give it a chance for ourselves because I had family there. It didn't work out, so we came back. But I was moving there the second time.
Thank God.
We thought it was a one-time thing.
Yeah.
Fuck it. Here's one more show. Let's go. I played the drums. It went excellent. And then I moved, and then
I was stuck.
She was fucked.
I was stuck with
no bass or drums.
I was stuck with singer number two, which
was a sloppy mess most of the time, unfortunately.
Yeah.
So while I was in Montana, she hired another drummer. Not named Steve this time, which was a good start.
Stefan.
His name is actually Frankie, for fuck's sake, is what we call him.
Yeah. That's a great name.
Yeah, that is a pretty good name.
So I'm in Montana. She's got another drummer. And so it's the three of them, no bass player, because I'm gone, because I was the bass player.
Still am.
Nobody can replace me, I guess.
Yeah.
And I came down
to visit for a surprise show. She throws a St. Patrick's Day party every year.
Cool.
So I came down on vacation kind of as a surprise, and we played a show at the Doll Hut. I played the bass, and I was like, man, I missed this. So...
But who the fuck are you playing with right now?
I was playing with nobody. I was not doing anything musical.
Somebody's drums got kicked over that night, fallen over or something.
With the cymbal, she fell on the cymbal stand. She almost
broke her. You need to come back and help me.
She almost broke her head open on the headstock of my bass.
Oh, no.
Wow. Yeah, that was pretty brutal. That was pretty sloppy.
Yeah.
So,
that's not just drinks, is it, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
That's even worse.
We think so.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
As far as you know.
Yeah. So I went back. I went home to Montana on vacation from vacation, and my wife and I both looked at each other and went, "We should just go back."
Yep.
So she called me like 2 weeks before I came back, and she was like, I fired her. Her singer at the time. I fired her.
Like, sorry, I didn't consult with you, but I fired her.
I fired her. And I said, that's fine. I'm coming back.
Yeah.
I said, good. Yeah.
Still
want
to play in the band, right?
Yeah. So,
I love that. I moved movie writing. I love that.
I moved back in July, like mid-July.
We had an ass load of shows. We played the Rainbow.
What year is this?
2019.
19? Okay.
I moved up to Montana October 2018. I was back in July 2019.
Okay.
And we had a shitload of shows booked.
Yeah, we played a ton of shows, just the three of us, as an instrumental.
Mm-hmm. As an instrumental, no vocals, guitar, bass, drums.
Carmen Bar.
Carmen Bar.
Did we play there? I don't remember.
I know you don't remember because we had a pool day and you fell over his bass amp on stage. His dad's like, he can't even stand right now. I'm like, he had a lot of sun.
And as soon as the show was over, my dad let me put all my stuff in my car, and then he grabs me by the shirt,
shovels
me into an Uber, and sends me home. And the worst part about it was, I had to pick up my wife from San Juan Capistrano Mission that night.
Oh,
and that did not happen. Oh, I woke up in the morning going, how'd you get here?
Oh, no.
She was like, fuck you.
Fuck you, buddy.
Oh, no.
Yeah, that was a memorable one.
Seriously, the next month, August, we had a bunch of other shows lined up, and our drummer just...
He started bailing on practice.
He started bailing on practice.
And I called him on it. I was like, dude, like...
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah.
I didn't say you're the weakest link or anything like that, but I basically said, we need to practice.
Yeah.
Like, this needs to happen.
There's two other people coming to this.
Yeah.
And then you got to insert that Michael Jordan meme, and I took that personally.
Yeah.
And he straight up quit on us the day of a big show.
Big show.
As soon as you bring it up.
In the morning, he texted us.
I got to be done after this, but I'll play the shows that I committed to. And then the day of the show.
And then the day before the show, he's like, I'll play the shows, whatever, and then I'm out of here. And then the day of the show, in the morning, he texted. He was like, nah, I can't do this. I'm out of here. And, like, I was waking up early for work at that time, so I saw the text, and I knew she was not seeing the text yet.
Yeah.
I was having a hard time about it the night before. I was having martinis about it.
I saw the text in the morning, and I texted her on the side. I was like, do not respond.
If I would have, that would have been bad.
And then
he was like, you know, you're very aggressive. You know, I don't really, like, I feel like I'm in harm's way. I'm like,
something like that. Ooh. Yeah, ridiculous.
Just play the fucking show.
Yeah. Right?
Like, just do what you're supposed to do. Yeah.
So I texted,
he's like, I don't feel safe.
Yeah.
I texted her, I said, don't read it.
Yeah.
Don't respond. Yeah. And do you want me to play bass or drums tonight?
Yeah.
And I can hear it in her text response. She's back in the hand, wiping her eyes, and she said, play the drums, man. And the rest is history.
That's where
we've been a two-piece since then. And the big show was at the Doll Hut.
Yeah.
Of all places.
But with good bands.
I love that.
That's amazing.
Fantastic. And we played that show, and we weren't sure what was going to happen after that, but we had everybody come up to us afterwards and go,
the fuck was that? Awesome. That was awesome. You guys sounded great.
And you were playing on the fucking little
I was
tiny,
playing on this
tiny
little, like,
Tama.
Cocktail kit that we kind of had donated
was,
to us
if
accidentally.
If you watch any of the videos, like, he's like...
Yeah, I...
He looks like an orangutan on that. I'm fucked up. I've been drinking all day. Like, so depressed. Like, what the fuck's going to happen at this good show?
Right.
And
yeah,
it turned out.
That drum kit was so small. I look like a monkey fucking a football. But
monkeys fuck footballs.
Gross! Yeah, oh, yeah, they can crush.
And the rest is history.
Nice.
We've been
a
two-piece since then. We've had at least 300 and 400,000 people tell us, oh, you got... I've written words to all your songs.
Fantastic. Oh.
Or,
keep them to yourself.
You guys need a bass player. Where's your who's your singer or whatever? Like
you should sing. I'm like, I have no fucking business singing.
Look.
None.
This ain't broke. So we're not trying to fix anything. We're broke, but this ain't
broke. We are broke.
I've written words to your songs. Good. Keep them to yourself.
But
exactly.
Seriously.
Yeah. Oh, fantastic. Exactly. So then, I mean, it's been a slew of releases since. So there's been like a, well, was not 2019, but then like release. Is there another one in the works?
Yeah.
Yes.
The big record.
The big one.
The big one. Record. So we played.
Yes, the record deal that we mentioned earlier.
The record deal.
Yeah. Okay.
So Savage Magic saw us play in January. They basically signed us on the spot and said, go record your record with whomever you like. Bring us. A mastered and vinyl master, and we're good to go.
Fuck yeah.
We want to do a 12-inch. We'll press however many, and I'm like, what the fuck? Like, what? I don't know how this works. Like, how do we?
That's how it works.
That's how it works. Yeah.
She texted me, and I didn't believe her.
Yeah.
Oh, he wants to do a record.
I'm like,
he
called me Monday,
okay.
too.
Yeah, I bet he does. Yeah, sure, all right. And then he's like, no, he really wants to do a record. And I was like, oh, fuck.
Well, we're
going
to have
to
talk with him.
Guess we're going to have to.
So how many songs on the record?
13.
13.
Woo!
Sweet. That's all we got. Yeah.
Sweet.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we ended up going with Toshi Kasai to record.
Okay. Shout outs. Where at?
Yeah.
He does all the Melvin stuff.
Awesome.
Tool, yeah. Foo Fighters.
He's done all. He's done all
great.
The Melvin stuff. He's worked with Dave Matthews. Tool.
So where's
Foo
the spot?
Fighters.
Where did you go to? Where
he's
are you going to?
He's up in Burbank.
Yeah, cool. He's in Burbank.
Yeah. Sweet.
Burbank. What's the other? There's some other. Name.
Is there a name of a studio?
Yeah. Sound of Sirens.
Okay.
Sound of Sirens. Studio.
Cool. Yeah. Gotta check it out.
We did it in 3 days. We got drums done in the first 2 days and. Some scratch guitar we kept, and I went back for a third day and did 13 songs in a day.
Fuck sweet. Yeah.
That's okay. Awesome.
It's off to master right now.
Yeah. Oh.
And.
Yeah. You're in the mastering stage. Mixing's done.
Mixing's done.
You're fucking over the hump, right?
Yeah. We're over the hump.
Yeah.
We're getting it mastered, and then we got to do the hardest part, which is decide the track order.
Which we figured that out already.
And then we send it off to get pressed and printed.
Cool.
Okay.
That's epic.
Fuck
what are you guys... Yeah, once it's out, what are you going to do? You going to try and tour with it? You going to try and...
We don't know.
I don't know. Yeah. I mean, it's very nice. It's very nice merch
well,
to have.
So
at least one video.
Savage Magic is... they've got bands also signed in Europe.
Okay.
So
we're going next year.
We're going next year already just on vacation.
For my 40th birthday.
Yeah. Nice.
We're going for her 29th birthday.
Yes.
But we're going to maybe try and play some shows over there.
Yeah.
In Europe,
over there.
Meet those
kind of promote the record a little bit.
Yeah.
Totally.
That'll be awesome.
Yeah, label mates over there are like.
Yeah, yeah. All about it. All about
great.
It. Because the show we played with them in January, they had a couple bands. They had a band from Texas. They had a band from Germany come over and play the show. And the band from Germany, like, they were all about it. So they've been constantly hitting us up. Like,
they
when
had
you
a big crush on you.
Send us your stuff. Send us your EPK. Send us your album when it's ready and
fuck
all that kind of
gang.
Stuff. So
that's rad.
Yes,
that's awesome. Get over there.
Yeah, videos.
We've made a video.
We have made two videos, homie. We made a video with Trainwreck.
That's true.
Singer.
Yeah.
Part
yes, it was.
Trainwreck and Steve 2.0. Which is actually a decent video. We paid some money for that. That was good, but nothing to see. And
the Timothy video.
Yeah.
What about this album?
Not
yet.
This album, yeah, we're trying to figure.
Words of advice: start now.
Yeah,
I know.
We're
doesn't have to be complicated, right?
Yeah, we're going on our third. Yeah, we want 13, and
we've definitely been talking about making a video.
Like COVID, didn't you guys do like some live streams? Like it doesn't have to
every
be
week.
We go live every Thursday.
Then
we went,
you have at least one video.
We went live before we came here.
Nice. Yeah. There you go. Fuck yeah.
Every Thursday,
Three song Thursday.
Tyler invented Three Song Thursday.
I like it.
Late April 2020. Nice. He's like,
it's been going since.
Yeah.
Fuck. That's awesome.
He's like, we got to do this.
We've gone live
like,
and done three songs almost every week since the pandemic started.
The same three songs, right?
No. yeah.
We've been practicing the same three songs live.
You're so fucking tight.
Three fucking years.
I can't wait till we put those three songs on a record.
No, what we do is we post our catalog and we let people request what songs they want to hear.
Nice. It's awesome. It's genius.
That's a good policy.
Sometimes it's fantastic. Sometimes it sucks.
Hey.
Like tonight we had literally zero viewers.
Yeah, my wife tuned in right at the very end. She's like, I made it.
We had just got
you
done
did.
Playing
We were done
three.
And she was there for the last half of the last song.
Sweet.
God bless your wife.
I appreciate you,
my
baby,
wife failed miserably tonight.
She was busy.
I think it would be great if we did something like this, but we played the same three songs and wore the same shit and tried to do the same exact thing. Like,
same
imagine
movement.
If you tried to
oh my,
choreograph.
That's fantastic.
So like
even the banter.
Yeah. So
like
then
whatever we
your
said the
video
first
has come out
the
every
same
week.
Script every
yeah,
time.
Yeah,
yeah. It just looks the same every time you release it, but the timestamp's different.
And it is live, and it's not a playback. Yeah.
At some point,
we hold up. We hold up today's paper.
Today's date.
Yeah.
There you go. Tuning in, Albert's like. Here's today.
Yeah, we can just start it with a close-up of the phone, dude. Yeah, you know, Thursday, June 22nd. You know, to start the stream right like that, close-up, and then pull away.
That's a good experiment.
And then it's the exact same everything else.
Yeah. People are like, why do you have so many videos of the same video?
Don't worry about it.
No, it's a different video.
It's what the people want.
It's yeah.
We're delivering. Want. It's consistency.
Yes. Can I have a... Can
yeah, we, I'll go here.
I'm due if you're getting up.
we can crush, right?
Oh,
so
yeah.
The idea,
oh yeah,
when there is cans, because it's always guest choice. Sometimes they pick cocktails. We can't crush those. Cans, we like to crush, and it's like the smallest surface you can get away with. I don't know who's winning right now between
Nick is
the flattest.
I think Nick's winning.
Oh shit!
Nick's probably
he is the flattest, but he's
but
like the most spaced out. So I mean, give it your best.
Yeah.
It's
straightest right. down.
The,
and
you know,
flattest.
The prize is bragging rights. You know,
yeah,
there's
yeah.
no.
Yeah,
there's no plaque or anything.
Yeah.
Down for a good
puppy.
Challenge.
I hope there, I don't step on anybody's.
I would advise.
Oh, no, you're fine.
Yeah, I would advise.
Whoa,
on the
that's
carpet.
Really good.
Let's
good.
See. Oh, she's definitely
ooh,
winning.
That is nice.
Yeah. Yep, she's the leader.
Is nice.
Yeah.
805s are a little. All right.
Thank you, kind sir.
Nick, I think you do have some bonus points here because the tongue
tap
one,
is...
it went back in.
That is, I would
Ryan,
say that's
Ryan,
that's a special
so
case.
So there is something about that. So you know,
it's well practiced.
There's
it's
no
well
set.
Practiced.
There's no set rules. So I
oh,
think,
it's gentlemen's rules. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
all,
I think
I dig it.
It's
yeah.
honor system.
Honor system.
Always.
Gentlemen.
Uh-huh. Right.
Yeah.
But we have one true cans. We have a
yeah. We'll show you the prizes at the
we
end.
Have a,
okay.
a beer can and a seltzer can that are like, you know, if you beat that,
yeah, you get
yeah,
you
get,
knock
that
like a trophy.
One off and it's
nice. It goes on the wall.
Yeah. We save
that one. Can goes on the wall.
Yeah.
Like I think now noted. If one of you hit it, we'll hear it and we'll be like,
yeah.
oh
no,
you know,
shit.
It'll be
this is
yeah.
it.
It's the one.
But it's you know it's one in thousands. It's very rare.
Oh yeah,
one true cannon.
Okay, now I got goals.
I know,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
I got another try.
We're always chasing the dragon. We're
I
trying
like
to one true
yeah.
cannon.
Chasing the dragon
every time. That's oh yeah.
Yeah, I dig that artwork.
Yeah, I love this artwork. Yeah, oh, I gotta do this.
It's
oh,
my,
oh yeah, there you go.
Mr. Brian yeah. Walsby, he's done.
Yeah, these are great visuals.
He's done a lot of rock and roll.
I need my
drawings,
my water bottle
album covers, all the things.
Yeah.
Look at that.
He's not doing our cover, but he's doing
this
our merch.
This looks so much better when it's closer.
We've got those stickers. We just got those this week.
Cool.
Yeah, Monday or Tuesday.
And we've got shirts coming with that.
Limited edition.
With
so
that same design.
Hell yeah.
Let us know what size you guys need.
Whoa.
Large.
Whoa.
Send them on over. Not today.
We'll DM you.
Not today. My size differs every
We'll
week,
slip
so.
Into those DMs.
We tried to guess your sizes, but we're probably not right.
That's fine.
And we probably don't have the size because We just have our old shirts that are limited.
We're all boys schmediums, and we're all 28-inch waist.
Yeah. Told you.
Yeah, I know.
I told you. I guess
that's
we guessed them.
So you did know. Yeah.
I kind of.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't think we are.
No. I'm a youth large, okay?
Me too. Yeah. Me too, yeah.
So I got to know, what's playing in the house when you're growing up? Like, what are you listening to, like, music-wise?
What are your parents playing you? What are you
playing? Oh, my God.
Your parents are older than mine.
They are. They are a lot older than yours. My mom listened to a lot of, like, Christian music, like worship music and stuff like that.
Yeah. Creed.
But
they're inspirational.
Creed was too heavy for my mom.
You didn't see the video.
But my dad was, he listened to a lot of Amy Grant.
Jesus.
Also Christian.
And,
yeah.
Yes. At that time she was.
Yeah.
At that
time she was.
So she made pop songs and went to Satan. Yeah. Yeah. I understand.
Blasphemy.
Yeah, yeah.
My dad, we listened to a lot of Mannheim Steamroller.
Yep.
Ooh. And
amazing harmonies.
Right?
Yeah.
Amazing drumming.
Yeah.
Good old shout out to Chip Davis. He's never going to listen to this, but that's all right.
He's shout out to Chip. Chip's listening. Chip's a big fan.
Chip always listens.
Good old Chip.
Chip, you're
old
on line Chip. Three.
But,
you know?
Allegedly. But,
what would you like to say to the band,
the
Chip?
The biggest one, my dad listened to a lot of Huey Lewis on the news.
Fuck yeah.
That's good.
Love me and, some Huey. And as a repayment to him, I've taken him to see Huey Lewis probably 3 or 4 times.
Fuck yeah. Yeah.
And before Huey had all of his ear shit.
Yeah, going deaf.
Going deaf and all the kind of tinnitus shit he had. Right. Like, oh my God. He's so good live.
He's so good.
So good.
Yeah.
That voice is unbelievable.
And like the first memory I have of seeing Huey Lewis live is years ago, probably 25-ish years ago now. We saw him at, I think, the San Diego County Fair.
Sweet.
And like my dad was all into it. I was all into it. And my brother, who's 3 years younger than me, was sitting there with his hands over his ears and crying the whole time.
Because
it was too
late.
Yeah. Too loud.
Oh,
too loud. Which is hilarious because that's Huey Lewis's line in Back to the Future. It's too loud.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And my brother was just hands over the ears, bawling his eyes out because it's too loud. I don't like this at all.
Yes, it's true. I'm so happy to be. He's like, no,
I don't like this at all. Fuck.
That's a big Kane does too.
It is, yeah. But he likes our music.
He does like our music, but he does.
He does. He does plug his ears. I think he's discovering that shit sounds different when you've got your hands over your ears.
We're
talking about my son. He's almost 2 years old. He's starting to figure out like he can plug his ears and shit sounds different in his head when he's got his hands over his ears than when he doesn't.
That's
there
good.
Has been shows where I'm like, what a terrible system. Oh, it's a good band, though.
I just don't.
The Doll Hut.
The Doll Hut. Yeah.
I just don't even go in to any live music place without earplugs in now.
Yeah, I carry earplugs with me at all times.
What?
Yep.
What?
Yep.
Huh?
Yeah, what?
Yeah. Yeah.
What?
Right.
I don't
it's exactly what. I don't, like, I don't like when I lay down in bed and I'm just like,
I did
that's,
two. I did,
that's literally my whole life.
I did two runs with an active rock project out of Jersey, and they had we did a bunch of dates. One time I was on bass, one time I was just tour managing, and all of the openers were the worst local metal bands you can think of.
Oh, Jesus
so
Christ.
I've just woke up. It's 5:30 p.m. and I'm opening the stage door.
Oh man!
No, thank you.
It's
brutal. From then on, unless I'm in the fucking bus. Earplugs.
Yeah.
I'm just leaving the.
That's fair.
Earplugs.
Well, that's
just, fair.
That's good on
not
you.
Gonna do
that's
it.
Fair.
You
yeah.
Wanna...
You know what that makes you is fucking smarter than us.
It stabbed me in the ear.
Took me until I was about 25, 26 to realize that earplugs were a good idea.
No.
And then ever since
this year I just started wearing earplugs under my motorcycle helmet.
Ah.
It'll get you. How long do you
want
to play for?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I'll play for 3 hours. I'm not going to be able to hear for a week, but I'm going to play for 3 hours without earplugs in.
But how many years is what he's trying to say?
But how many can afford Huey's surgeries?
Yeah.
It's hip to be a square.
It's hip to be a square.
Very hip to be square. Dude.
I don't know. I've been standing in front of bass amps for 20 years, and I can't hear anything.
Highly recommend. Even I'll take even if I have just one in a pocket, I'll bite it in half and take the two halves and just anything. Really? If I don't even have that, guess what? I'm going to get fucking toilet paper.
Yeah, toilet paper.
And I'm just taking tiny little wads and just throwing it there. Because
when,
at the
when
end
you're
of the
playing?
Night, any wherever.
At a show,
if it's
playing a show.
If it's loud, I'm not taking it all in. Yeah. I'm not supposed to be standing in front of that drum set. And even if I am, that's meant for the people all the way back there, not me.
I can't hear on stage. If I wear earplugs, I can't hear any of the high frequencies or any of the feedback, any of the things.
Yeah.
So I can't wear earplugs.
I don't need any of
on stage anyway.
You gotta get some good in-ears then.
There's a whole bunch of crazy technology.
Pretty fucking expensive too.
We have to introduce you to the
ones. I was gonna say you ain't seen the $20 ones I got on Amazon.
Yeah. Or there's these there's new earplugs that are like $15 or something on Amazon, and they have like a hole in the middle or something with like a weird corkscrew looking thing.
In.
So they
let
the high frequency in.
Yeah.
So do you guys sell earplugs?
Not anymore.
No.
Well, that was a pretty good pitch.
Yeah. Not after.
Well, actually, you can put put in the word the Tragic Radicals and get 10% off these earplugs.
Sold.
Promo code TRAGRAD in all caps. 15% off.
Is it gonna happen?
Trad-rad?
Trad-rad.
Oh, his wife said no. My wife said absolutely.
Knuckle tats.
Yeah, Natalie said no. Jen said
my wife said
handle,
my
baby.
Wife said my wife free-handed me a stack of divorce papers.
Just in case.
Don't fucking do it,
just
motherfucker.
Just one of the tragically radical reasons.
But she said I could get Trad-rad on the license plate of my van, so.
Ah, that's good.
Okay.
It fits.
Just surprise her. Tramp stamp.
Yeah. Right.
You said license plate, right?
Trad-rad.
These are the license plate of the body.
Each side of your spine.
Trad-o-rad.
Oh, Jesus, now we're Irish.
You're welcome, honey. Get all in there.
Get all up in there.
I can just picture you taking a shit in the woods and just spreading them. Trad-rad.
I dig it. I like it. I think we need to start a movement. A bowel movement.
There may be a whole wave of tattoos now inspiring.
I like it.
Is that going to be our doll hut tattoo? Doll hut on the cheeks with the picture over on the tramp stamp?
Yes.
Well, you forgot.
Yes.
World famous.
Yeah.
World famous.
So world famous are gonna be the shoulder blade wings. World famous doll hut with the picture of the neon sign on the tramp stamp. Hell yeah, dude. They're gonna let me in for free for sure this time.
Yeah, that's the time. That's the deal. If you get a doll hut tattoo, your cover charge is covered forever.
Wow. So they say.
Is the
That's the
unspoken deal.
I mean, I can get you a tattoo gun for like $12.
Let's do this. Oh, can I get some earplugs with that?
Yeah. Absolutely, as long as you use promo
frequency canceling earplugs, please. Yeah.
Just give me
how many tats are we at now?
Oh shit.
Uh huh.
I have no clue.
You're more than any of us.
Okay, 100.
No. 90. I think I'm in the 30s or 40s.
30s or 40s.
I got fewer than that.
But yours are big.
But no, I have
mine
sleeve,
are fucking silly
sleeve,
little tinies.
And a spare. I mean, a lotus.
Is it just on your arms?
I got back of my legs, my feet, back of my neck.
Do you have favorites?
Do you have a favorite?
Favorites.
I know.
Ooh, that's probably this one, half sleeve.
Right.
Pretty fucking dope.
That's
gnarly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a good
pretty
one.
Fucking dope.
I got a buddy
pretty
that
details.
Did his leg in Star Wars. Tom.
Yes.
Yeah. Tom the Cones.
You got Star Wars on your leg, too.
Man. I do. I
ooh, double Star Wars.
The old Mandalorian.
Ah,
Mythosaurus
fuck
skull.
Yeah.
Cool. Oh, nice.
Yeah.
That one's old. I've had that one for...
Older than the sleeve?
Oh, yeah. Oh,
okay.
So nice. The original one here was just the Rebel Empire yin-yang kind of outline.
Gotcha.
And then a while... I don't know how long ago. I don't know. 14, 15, something like that. I got it filled in and got the half sleeve around it and then the Serenity around that.
Yeah, fucking dope work.
Nice.
Yeah. Is it all the same artists, different artists?
Oh, my God.
You're fine.
And then how long do you think, how many hours?
This was, the half sleeve here was all the same artist. Big shout out to Colin at Gold Rush Tattoo in Newport
Gold
Beach.
Gold Rush Tattoo.
Gold Rush.
This was...
It's still there in business right now, right?
Yeah, it is. Yeah, it's still
shout
there.
Shout out Gold Rush.
Gold Rush.
This was...
10% off. He's treasure.
Yeah, I wish. This was...
Buy the earplugs.
4 or 5, 6 hour sessions.
Right on.
Wow. That's a long time.
That's a long ass time,
That's
dude.
A long fucking time.
Yeah.
And then this one was... One session, 1 8-hour, I think, session.
Yeah.
At Gold Rush, different artist.
Gotcha. Okay.
Nice.
I mean, I ask because that's like all shading.
Yeah,
like, that one
is.
Oh yeah.
Because I got.
It's a lot of color too.
Because he did the outline of the TIE fighter in one session. It was the outline of the X-wing in the second session. The third session was the shading on both ships. And the fourth session was the kind of the background, the
color,
the spiral, and the kind of the all the background here.
The atmosphere.
Sounds about right.
Jesus,
yeah,
it's just a long fucking time.
The worst part was these points way up in the armpit. Oh. Yeah,
armpit is weird.
Where it got real
odd.
Close.
Yeah,
yeah,
but
my inner arm didn't hurt at all.
No, biceps like right pretty here. Good. This, I mean,
but
this only took like
that,
biceps
beautiful.
Good.
Two
it's just
yeah,
this.
Getting
yeah.
up
right
to your armpit.
Fucking,
Oliver,
right
I love
in the corner.
Thank
beautiful.
You.
That's right,
yeah.
dude.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
That's
this was,
gorgeous.
But this was only like 9 hours total. 1 6-hour, 1 3-hour, something
that's
like
beautiful.
That.
Nice. Dig it.
Yeah, yeah. Awesome.
The colors
yeah.
are really cool.
Shout out
my elbow sucked. Elbows tattooing on bone, like little elbow bone. Oh my god.
I've got one.
Sucks.
I've got one here that just hitting the ribs, the floating ribs.
Oh,
you do?
God.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't ever see you without a shirt.
Oh,
what the fuck is that? Get that out of here.
He's an anarchist.
Yeah,
I got that a long time ago, dude.
I got
this a long time ago.
What the hell is wrong
ago.
With you? That was a bad idea.
But these floating ribs, oh my
yeah,
god. Before I drank so much beer, I had no gut to insulate any of that shit, so it was just skin and floating ribs, and man.
The fucking collarbone's gnarly, feet are gnarly.
Dude, yeah, my roommate's got his feet like all done, and that's what he
it
said.
It hurts like hell.
Yeah.
Dude, it's just that. The thin layer of skin that doesn't get sun or anything
yeah,
like that.
Right?
It's not weathered at all, and it's just the needle, it's just hitting your skin, but it's fucking
hitting
your bone
yeah.
at the same
time.
Like, oh, fuck.
Your feet have all those little tiny bones
oh,
in
my
it.
God.
Oh, yeah, I would never get a foot one. Yeah.
And then you tip them after that.
Yeah. Thank you, may I have
give
another?
Give me my money back.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
That was miserable.
You thank you. Thank you for the pain.
A favorite one?
Well, I don't have a favorite one, but I like my newest one. My newest one's kind of fun. It's a Small Fry. There's a 30s cartoon where Small Fry thinks he's a big fry.
Oh.
And goes out skipping school.
Oh.
Like fish school.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
I get it.
And
yeah.
goes to the local pub and shoots pool and smokes cigarettes with the big
allegedly.
Fries.
Allegedly.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, allegedly. And then the big fries punk his ass and send him through like a scary little moment of life.
Pinocchio-ish sounds.
Have you ever seen the Tubes video, She's Beauty?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
So, kind of like that, except it's scary.
Okay.
Okay.
And he comes out on the other side, runs to his mama. He's like, oh, I don't want to be a big fry. So, there's Small Fry's little story.
Oh, great.
Nice.
Nice.
But I came up with it last minute. My mom was here in March, and she was getting, like, a hand tattoo, and I was like, oh, Jesus Christ.
April. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So I found a guy. He's the guy. He's actually doing our album cover.
The
same
oh, there you go.
Nice.
Cover.
Yeah.
Yeah, because he did fucking great work.
That's good sourcing of an artist.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Tattoo artists know how to draw.
You trusted him with
yeah.
your skin before you trusted to see how he drew. That's really awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly.
Imagine if he was off. You're like, yeah.
If you can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball. Yeah,
you can still do our artwork.
Yeah, it was. He did a great job on
yeah, that looks
my mom's
good.
Hand, and then I was sitting in the chair, and he's like, "I got some free time." I'm like, I gotta think of something real quick. Gotta think of something real quick. Mr. Garcia, he's a good dude.
Where's he at?
He's in Brea. He works at Old Time Tattoo.
Okay.
Shout out Old Time.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And he's doing our album cover right now.
Right now.
Put him up to it. Cause, I mean, we tasked Walsby with the two-headed dragon thing, and he spit it out in a couple of days.
Nice.
And I'm like, cool, that's going to work great
for
merch items.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
I want my album cover to be...
It's an album cover.
It's tits and ass.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, the full T, the full A.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
So, we're waiting to see what happens.
Yeah, he's working on it now, hopefully.
Dope. Well, this episode comes out like July 4th.
So your birthday.
It's my birthday.
Oh,
nice. What a birthday
present.
Happy
birthday.
I'll also be 29.
I don't have to get you anything now.
Born on the 4th of July. That's fantastic. Indeed. Yeah. Is it always a party?
Oh, yeah.
Anything planned?
I mean, it's 4th of July.
Oh, I'm going to be in Montana.
Okay.
I'm going on vacation.
Okay.
Oh, sweet.
My aunt lives up in Montana. She asked me, she goes, what do you want to do for your birthday? And my answer was, I just want to blow shit up.
Yes. Yeah, that's. I'm
so
sure you can do
said,
that in Montana.
Yes. We can do that.
Yeah,
no problem.
Yeah.
Yeah. No problem.
She's like, we just did.
Yeah, exactly. There's no rules up there. Yeah, yeah. They live outside town. There's no weird anything. Whatever. Allegedly.
No, just different set of rules, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
I mean,
exactly.
Also. Giant open spaces, houses
stacked
on top of each other.
My aunt and uncle own multiple acres out in the country. So.
Michigan, you know, you just go to a store, buy a bunch of festival balls, go to your backyard, shoot them all off.
Yeah,
like, and all is well.
Yeah, all is well.
All is well.
Do you have a booze of choice for the birthday, the evening?
Well, they don't have 805 up there.
You like?
You know what though?
You got a brewery.
They probably.
I tell you. I'll tell you what though. There's a local. My family up there lives in Billings, Montana.
Yeah,
makes sense.
And there's a brewery there called Angry Hank's.
Ooh, Angry Hank's.
And one of the best beers from town is an Imperial Red.
Jesus.
That they call Street Fight.
Yes.
Nice.
Like 10%, 9%.
Something like that. Yeah. It's like 8.5 or something like that.
You'll be fighting your family in no
time. Exactly. Exactly.
With pyrotechnics.
Yeah, right.
So for the local beer, it's that. It's an Imperial Red. It's called Street Fight by Angry Hank. So they have a microbrewery in town.
Perfect.
And it's fucking great.
Yeah. Use,
and
real great water up there. So the beer is, I mean...
And there's
Here's
another they up in Montana it's like Scotch ales are very popular it's kind of a northern thing
stouts,
kind of in general
porters, stuff
stouts
thicker
porters
beers.
All the heavy darker beers
warm.
Because you drink them and you fill up and you stay warm in the winter there's
are we
another...
just fucking Minnesota
garlic bread
garlic bread. That's rude.
Racist. It's fair. It's fair. It's fair. It's fair.
But there's a brewery out of Missoula, and they brew a beer called Cold Smoke, and it's a Scotch ale, and fucking delicious.
All right. A good Scotch ale.
That's what I'm drinking up there is Street Fight and Cold Smoke.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Is beer the booze of choice?
Dangerous.
Yes.
All right.
Absolutely.
Sounds like it. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, it's open bar. Everything's on the menu. There's
anything's on
booze
the menu.
Of choice.
Blood.
Yeah. What? Yeah. Yeah. What do you? What do you order?
Well, it depends. I like vodka.
Okay.
But
straight? Red Bull.
Vodka soda.
Yeah. Vodka
lime,
sodas
lemon,
with lime.
Olive.
Lime.
Okay.
Yeah. Those
vodka
are great.
Soda lime.
I like, but I mostly drink beer because then I'm a little bit more well-behaved.
Beer keeps it chill.
Allegedly.
Beer keeps it a little bit.
I wasn't very well-behaved last night. We played Fullerton Day of Music yesterday.
We did.
Hell yeah.
We did. We played at Bootleggers.
Sweet.
Oh, yeah, Bootleggers is great.
That's dope. Like fucking 10 minutes that way.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And we,
did you guys
we were drinking 9%.
We ordered a few, what's it called? Golden Chaos?
Golden Chaos.
Which is 8.5%
Belgian.
We've had it.
I was a little bit fucked up when we finally went on. The band before us took their sweet ass time.
Yeah, we were supposed to. We were supposed to play at 7:30.
We went on at
8:30. We started at almost 9 o'clock.
Whoa!
And the cops were getting called.
And the cops. What? We were at when we got off the stage. The server over there was like,
"Thank God that was really your last song." Glad
you guys stopped because. We had some shut, noise complaints coming in.
At bootleggers on the day of music?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Get the fuck
that's
out not of here.
That's yeah. exactly what we said.
It's across the street from the cop shop, so.
Who cares?
It's the day of music.
It's fucking day of music.
That's what bootleggers. We said. That's what we said. What is happening? No.
Did you get two saucy broads?
No, we did not.
Not this time.
Oh, my God.
Normally we do. Delicious. Normally we do.
We done did fucked up.
You know, that's a cardinal sin. You were that close, and you didn't get it.
Well, my wife's on keto, so, like, I try to be sensitive.
Who cares about your wife?
Don't they do a cauliflower crust there?
I don't know.
I think they do.
I feel like they do.
It's not the same.
Shout out to Saucy Broads. Saucy Broads.
It's delicious.
Yeah, no, it's good. Definitely.
But we are loud. I mean... My setup is pretty loud.
As two people, we make a lot more noise than most six-person bands. So.
Yeah, what amp are you bringing?
JCM 800, full stack.
Yes.
And
don't fuck around.
And a bass amp.
And a bass amp.
Yes.
Don't fuck around.
Yes.
And a bass amp.
How could I fuck around? It's only two of us.
Yeah. Yeah, then live, where's the bass signal running from? Is it an octave on the guitar? Is it?
No, she's got an A-B split.
Oh, fantastic.
So the A channel goes through the guitar pedal board, through the JCM 800 and the full stack.
Bass
and
the
B channel goes through it also goes through the pedal board and then...
Great.
Yeah, into the bass amp.
Yeah, so if I wanted to switch it off, I can, but I don't. I just leave it on.
Mm. Mm-mm.
But...
Yeah, why?
Yeah. No, all the way up, all the way up, all the way up. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm.
But it makes for a lot of schlepping. I mean, your fucking drum set right now. He's like, I just want to downsize. Every time he says that, he adds. Shit. No. How many pieces is your
it's
set
big,
right
yeah,
now?
Yeah, I was seeing. It's like, you know, four or five times or something. You got. Yeah.
Oh, man.
Who are you?
I just had to pack it all up earlier. So I've got three rack toms.
Yeah, I saw that.
Two floor toms, one on each side.
Nice.
Plus the snare. Yeah. Double bass kick. I run a remote hat, so I play the hi-hat on the right side of the kit.
Uh-huh.
Yes,
and I've got a ride, three crashes,
come on, man.
A china, and two cowbells.
Love it,
because he has no
don't
time to help
around.
With any
don't
other
fuck
setups.
Around.
He's like, I got a downsize. I don't. I'm
this
sick
is a
of
lot
shit.
Of shit. This is a lot of shit to schlep.
My,
and then
my
I played on somebody else's kit with,
me spending
a,
money.
With
he's
some
like,
chimes. I was like, maybe I need to get some chimes too. Y'all got any more percussion?
Yeah.
The backline he played at last week when we played Pasadena had like a very simple setup, but they had chimes, and I didn't know when. When
so
this
every
is
single
happen,
song had
and
time.
So
oh,
like,
yeah, every
I'm
single.
Pissing my pants.
Yeah, your birthday is coming up.
Time.
Yeah, you better get me some chimes for my birthday, bitch.
Fuck you. No, I already got you something. Remember?
Allegedly.
I got you a podcast.
A podcast and a Guitar Center rewards card so I can buy my own shit.
Yeah. You can't use that
cash.
Towards your credit card.
I have one compound hyphenated word for you. It's Rototoms.
Yeah.
Rototoms.
Yeah. Those things, the little, they're just like, you know, heads.
Just a head with, like, a crank on it. Yeah.
Like single, doublet.
Oh, do they call them a stand?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
You would break that immediately. That would be broken or knocked down.
I mean, he's already got three rack toms.
Connected to a rack tom.
Can I get that one more time?
Yeah, and then you have the full Van Halen.
I think you're on
something.
That is
the full
great.
Van Halen.
Yeah, you know what else you need? You need alternate tuned toms.
Ooh.
So instead of just doing three, get one that extends and goes on top of it.
What?
So you can have like E, E flat.
Oh, so for different tuning.
Yeah.
Chromatic
toms. So then you got six toms.
That's hot.
You do
so then
six different notes.
You're harmonizing in like really any key.
So you can.
So it's just sort of like a keyboard.
My
drum
solos are 39 minutes long, and I only hit any drum one or two times. Yeah.
We're going for once, dude. One.
I'm just spinning around in circles and shit.
First drummer with an automatic spiral. Chair. You can set the speed that you turn at.
Oh my god.
Automatic throne.
Fucking automatic throne. Hey.
No, I'll just
trademark that shit.
Yeah, trademark.
Yeah, I'm going to put it right in with the headphones.
Forget that.
Yeah.
I'm going to take that to the next level. I'm going to stay stationary and make the kit spin around.
That's what I'm talking about.
That's better.
Yeah, you don't turn for the drums.
I turn for nobody. Yeah. The drums turn for me.
So you keep your sticks
in place. Turn around for what?
Your sticks don't move.
The part of the solo that kills them is when you just take the stick and throw it in the air and it just bounces off the kit. While you take a break.
No, that's when
it's like a Rube
Goldberg
machine.
I like to call that
machine.
The Plinko solo.
Yeah. The Plinko solo. Yeah.
And that's when you're going to get your car to pull it up.
I think we've got something here.
This is, yeah.
Golly.
You heard it here first.
But
first,
will it?
And the only thing you hear behind the whole solo is turn around. Turn around.
Yeah, you have it on a sample pad. Just
and I'm just standing there with my guitar on feedback.
Uh-huh. Thank you. That's been our whole 39-minute set. Yeah, yeah. We're the Tragic Radicals.
Sorry, I was too drunk to play my guitar tonight.
Vinyls sold out. Yeah. Shirts sold out.
Done. Yeah. Done.
The Hollywood Bowl won't know what hit them.
There's half a sticker left. Half a sticker left.
I like it.
But will it fit indoors at the doll hut?
Absolutely not.
It has to be outdoors.
The doll hut is about the smallest stage that my kit can fit on.
This will be the first time a drummer plays on the ground.
No.
Oh, wait. Was there someone else that did that?
You had to play. No.
No, that was... We played at a place called Liquid Zoo up in the valley.
It was glorious.
And the stage was so small, she played on the floor.
All my shit was on the floor, too.
I set up.
You took the whole stage.
My kit filled up the entire small-ass stage.
Sounds like your stage was, like, this tall.
And the stage was, like, 4 feet off the ground.
So it was an open mic stage, like a comedy.
Yeah, I was going to say this sounds like a good bar or something.
Yeah.
And so all her stuff was set up on the floor.
Yeah.
She played on the ground.
I would sometimes come up the stairs a little bit and go, "We doing good?" Yeah. Come back down. I'm like, well, I'm down here. It's fine. I'm not meant to be seen. I'm not meant to be
heard.
Well,
never mind the other place that we played up in the valley called Witch's Brew.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
That was the same thing, except this stage was 8 inches off the floor.
That was bad.
But it had a pony wall all the way around it. Ooh. And so by the time I set up my kit, there wasn't any room for all her stuff, but she couldn't set it anywhere else because of the pony wall, so you wouldn't be able to hear anything. Right. So the ground, and I couldn't hear anything because the fucking pony wall was
in the
way. I
had my stack behind you. I couldn't hear anything.
Oh, that's right.
I had my pedal
board
on the fucking floor.
Oh, my God.
And I was like, this is fucking terrible.
The venue was great.
Take
me out. The stage was terrible.
On a Thursday night in fucking
God.
Wherever the
and
fuck
we
were, it was
terrible.
We already
drove like 300 hours to get there and set
Dude,
up.
If,
oh, my God.
If
Van Nuys.
If one of us ever has to be on the ground, I say we point the amp towards the wall, and we're between the amp and the wall. And we face towards the wall.
I was going to say, if one of us is on the floor.
It's just the back of the amp. It's like,
at the back of you.
Yeah.
Just why you,
no,
why you perform.
No monitors allowed.
Good solution.
Yeah.
That's it. I mean, this is...
If you're not going to... If you're making me do this.
You might as well take that to the next level, and all of you wear assless chaps.
Oh.
Yeah. Face the wall.
Oh.
Assless
and
chaps.
Just lots
yeah, yeah.
of lots
drum
of
kit
the
facing
one,
the wall.
Two,
yeah,
one,
yeah.
I'd pay to see that show.
I would, too.
I'd leave and come back. There's a cover. No?
No, there's no cover.
There's no cover. It's the no cover tour.
We play.
It's the no cover tour.
Yeah, it's that
big
tour.
Bottom.
Exactly.
Big bottom.
Yeah.
Have you done the Continental Room?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah? You like that spot?
Day Music, we played it 2018.
18, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That stage is
17.
Not exactly
17.
Big.
17. 17. We played
that's
17.
A tiny,
for Day
that's
Music.
A tiny stage.
It's not exactly big,
yeah.
But at least you could probably fit on there.
But the curtains just get
the curtains.
Yeah.
The fucking curtains.
I'm like
Long Beach's Carsex, shout out Carsex. They have a great episode.
Dude, Carsex is so good.
Nigel the singer, he was like, "When I always wanted to play there." Because when I saw the curtain, it reminded me, and he went into this whole story about, like, you know, something he saw as a kid. And he's like, I was just so excited to play that venue because the curtain.
Curtain. Yeah. It's everything.
It's everything.
It's a nice reveal.
He's the singer. He's like laying on it.
Oh, he was everywhere.
Dude.
Oh,
yeah, in the crowd. On the bar. He was on the bar.
He was in the booths. Yeah. He was laying on people's tables. He's awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Great band. I like that bar. Awesome shit.
Car Sucks is awesome.
The room is great. It's exactly what it should. Do you have a favorite spot in Fullerton? Oh.
RIP Slide Bar.
Slide Bar's gone.
If we go back in years, the alley was awesome.
I love the Slide Bar.
If you guys from around there, the alley was awesome.
The alley? Yeah. Like that one?
Back alley?
No.
The alley. It's the gone. Alley. It's been gone for a long time.
I don't know
time.
What that is.
Back alley's still there.
Yeah. Back alley's still
back
there.
Back alley's still there, yeah.
Yeah. The alley was sick.
We played back alley day music.
Pretty much every year.
3 years in a row. 16, 17, 18. Four years in a row. 19. 16, 17, 19, yeah.
There's nowhere to play anymore.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's why we played at Bootleggers.
Yeah.
Yeah. And no one goes to shows.
Yeah.
That is absolutely true.
Yeah. Used to be people just went to shows. Like
all the time.
I'm gonna go.
Yeah.
There's a good place. We haven't played it yet, but they have shows all the time. Skate shop. Uh-huh.
Yeah. We've heard good things.
Yeah.
We've only heard good things.
Yeah.
It's tiny because it's a record shop.
Yeah.
It's super tiny. Yeah. I've been to shows there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wanna get us in there. But otherwise, I mean there's nowhere to play.
Yeah.
Slybar's gone. I was Slide Bar.
Yeah.
Love the Slide Bar.
Slide Bar.
The sound guy at the Slide Bar did a record for me in another band years before, and in that band, I couldn't even get there. So.
Oh. What? What the fuck?
That like everybody. Correct.
Yeah. We must have just knew the right people.
Yeah, it was a weird spot.
Yeah. So, I mean, that is gone. Continental Room is good, but their shows are very intermittent right now.
I feel like Slide Bar just turned into the Wayfair.
It did.
It's so far away, but like the place that everyone always played at was Slide Bar, and now since there's nowhere, it's like
it's the Wayfair.
The Wayfair is all right. I mean, Detroit Bar was better.
Detroit Bar was.
Shots fired.
I'll say the layout of Detroit Bar was not better.
Agreed.
I agree with you. The bar that they would never open up the stage area, so you just be like, what's over?
Is there noise over there?
Yeah.
Is someone playing?
Yeah.
Is there a jukebox? Yeah. Turn that down.
Yeah. But now it's just wherever it goes. Better than Tiki Bar.
It's definitely better than Tiki Bar. The Tiki Bar, dude.
Gross.
All right, here's a good story about the Tiki Bar. So like
the last
it's a parking
time,
story, right?
It was
No, it's not a parking story.
You can never find parking.
No.
The last time we played
it
at the
wasn't
Tiki
the
bar,
last time we played we gave not? Him another chance.
Oh, we did?
Oh.
Oh. All right. We gave
so
him another chance.
That was our bad, I guess.
One of the first times when we were a two piece we played there. We got there early, we're like, all right, cool, like we're gonna get there, we're gonna eat, we're gonna chill and play.
Yeah, like Duke's is across the street that has whatever.
Well, and they had food at the Tiki Bar.
Oh, okay.
Until a
I never
certain
ate
time.
That.
I've never eaten.
Well,
when
it's
neither.
A, when
that's
it's a Tiki
right.
Bar,
that's
part
he's,
of the, that's part of the story.
At the bar,
that's right.
Well, he's there before me trying to get a fucking drink.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's only
I
one
was
lady.
Standing
she's
at
always
the bar
getting ice.
It was the owner dude.
Kyle.
And he was like ignoring the fuck out of Tyler. I show up, he serves me a drink. I'm like, and he would like. I'm like, and we'd also like to eat. Oh, kitchen's closed.
I'm like, I've been here for 45 minutes, motherfucker.
Trying to get a fucking
I'm
beer.
I'm trying to order a beer and order some food, and the kitchen's closed. I haven't gotten a drink yet because he keeps, like, looking right past me. Yeah. And I'm like, I started playing an experiment.
Yeah.
I sat, I was in the stool.
You just squeezed your tits together. Slowly,
that's what he
slowly.
Did. That's what he did.
So I leaned forward on the bar.
He shaved his beard, did the whole thing.
Walked past me a couple times. I leaned further forward on the beard, put a little.
Would you
put
fuck
a
me?
I'd on,
fuck me.
You know, unbutton my shirt a little bit.
Start doing this.
Dude, I'm leaning all the way in the bar, waving at this.
Your
bartender.
Arm is halfway across
my
the other side.
My arm is
the
about
bar.
To grab the bottle and drink it for myself. Nothing.
What?
Yeah.
Nope. He was.
Nothing.
He didn't like
I
it.
I got one dude. Beer that night.
Wow.
I've got similar stories like that. Yeah.
It has to be a front.
Yeah.
Allegedly.
Like allegedly.
Like how?
For sure.
Like how? And how? Nice catch. Oh, tiki bar.
Well, and especially when.
And you know what?
When you're in the band, it's like, it wouldn't be such a big deal
if the venue wasn't so good.
Yeah.
Their sound guy.
Their sound guys are always really good. Always
Vince. We always pay the sound guy because he's so good.
Is it Vince?
Excellent.
Vince, Asian dude?
Yes.
Yeah, Asian dude. Yeah. And then there's a kid now, too, that's pretty decent.
Oh, that's fucking.
Trevin's been there for a while. I don't know if he's still there.
Their sound guys are so good.
He's
the
like
sound.
Wavy blonde.
Yep.
Yeah.
Trevin.
Yeah. Yeah.
Who's his dad?
Noodles. Offspring drummer.
Oh, drummer.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I heard that. Yeah.
Shout out Trevin. We have to have them both on the podcast.
Sure.
Let's get the Offspring on the podcast.
Dude, so good. Both and awesome dudes. I like the little back area where you can put your shit.
Yeah, the patio out back and shit.
Yeah,
and if you're lucky, they'll open the gate so you can load in and load out right there.
If you're lucky.
Oh, we just we don't ask.
We just open the door.
Yeah,
but
fuck this. Once
you get one person inside, then they can open the gate and everybody else can load in the back.
If you ever go for round three of No Park Zone, put on the show yourself. And then you can do like a split with the door, but then you're pretty much running the show. So you just got to get someone for the door.
It's a pain in the ass.
But they pay attention to you more.
Yeah.
That's what we notice is when you run it, they're more attentive
because they need their cut.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Yeah. Just so you know,
it's pretty wild. I mean,
it's pretty wild.
A lot of these places here, like we were very blessed last week. We got paid twice.
Mm-hmm. Fuck yeah.
We got $45 cut. And we got a $30 cut.
Fuck yeah.
Hell yeah, dude.
That
doesn't even pay my gas and drive from home.
There were no drinks involved. There's no drink tickets involved. Like, you can't even get a drink ticket.
Yeah. I hope you like being in a band.
At the Doll Hut.
The Doll Hut doesn't give you drinks for their canned beer?
No. Well, they don't.
If they have it in stock.
We shouldn't talk shit on the Doll Hut because...
You shouldn't.
No, let me do it.
Yeah, yeah, let Nick...
Yeah, let Nick...
You know what, though?
Let him do it all.
We've talked about it earlier, our Savage Magic show that we played there in January.
Yeah, yeah.
That was the first time ever since we became a band in the beginning of 2016 that we got drink tickets.
$200 and drink tickets.
And we got paid.
Nice.
Jesus.
I took my drink ticket. I've got it at home. I'm gonna frame that motherfucker with the show poster and the set list. This is the first time in 6 fucking years we got a drink ticket at the Doll Hut, and I didn't even spend it because it was so momentous of an occasion.
I didn't even ask for it. They just gave
they
it
just gave
to
it
me.
To
yeah,
me.
We didn't ask. We never ask for it.
Do you guys
Our wives pay
Twisted?
To get in there.
Twisted Soul?
Yeah, we play with them from time to time, yeah.
Oh yeah, my.
he's a co-owner.
That's what it says on his page.
Mr. Brennan.
Yeah, Mr. Brennan.
Yeah, yeah.
Big
yeah.
old Mike. Yeah. Old Mike.
Yeah.
What's your opinion
of Mike?
Yeah.
He's doing what he does. He's
That's
doing.
A very
he's
diplomatic
doing what
answer.
He's doing what show promoters do.
Yep.
Show promoter.
Carmen Bar, man.
I know,
played there a
I've
lot.
I've known him for
close.
The Carmen
Bar.
R.I.P.
Yeah. R.I.P. Man.
Gross. Yeah.
Dude, so gross.
Yeah.
Space dog.
When I saw Mike Brennan like shack up at Doll Hut. I was like, okay, I think
makes sense.
It's a better fit than
the
Carmen Bar.
Yeah, I think that's a place that he
agreed.
Will.
Because yeah.
it's
agreed.
Still open.
Well, yeah, I guess.
That's
but it's also like an institution.
They'll also work with his tactics.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's no standards there.
Mike Brennan has, he's like, let's do outside too.
Yeah.
Let's have rotating things.
Yeah, I like the outdoor stage thing. The outdoor
Otherwise,
stage cool.
you know what those, they're like, all right, 3 bands, it starts at whatever time, it ends at whatever time.
Yeah.
Yeah, it depends. I mean, he's booked us some all right shows, but. Again, we play there all the time.
Yeah.
He asks,
he's also very
he asks us to play
metal.
A lot. We're definitely on his short list.
We are.
And we've played a lot of shows for him at the Hut,
and,
especially.
And his
and
other
places.
His co-Twisted Soulers.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I
like,
think
we
he's,
appreciate
he's primarily
Twisted Souls
metal music,
yeah.
right?
Because they've so gotten hard. Us a lot of gigs.
He's always doing shows.
Yeah.
He works hard.
And
like,
You can't talk shit about that
he's
because
does,
he's booking.
No,
he's
working hard.
He's booking all the time. He's booking all sorts of people, and we've played with all sorts of people at the Hut at Twisted Souls
it's true.
Shows. Like, you can't talk shit about that.
Yeah,
and we appreciate him for calling us 3 times a week
to play shows at the Hut.
Because we're attention whores, we love to play.
And a lot of times we'll take the shows.
Yeah.
A lot of times we'll take the shows. If we don't have anything else going on.
You like to play? I don't know. It's just like you talk
so far. Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. So I like this year we're way ahead of our annual record for shows played this year so far.
So
how many this year already?
We are at, I think, 22,
hell
23.
Yeah.
Something like that.
Nice.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Fuck yeah.
And we're
tracking
about
on 35 is the high year.
35 is our record, and we've already played 22, 23. And
we got 22 on the books.
Yeah, we've got more scheduled than.
Fuck yeah.
Great. We're gonna beat the record.
I was going to say, the efficiency of a two-piece must definitely help with that.
It's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
The logistics are a lot easier.
Yeah. Yeah.
And we're good friends.
And helps.
That also helps.
So nice.
That also helps.
Huge.
Yeah.
Composition-wise, so how did these last 13, I mean, we can talk about just songwriting in general.
I'm going to take a break.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, go.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
Drain it.
Piss on the wall, Jay Giles.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can answer that.
Go for me too, would you?
Yeah.
Go for me. So when do these ideas come about? How do they get together?
Well, when the band first got together, I had written most of the songs already. Some of them had played in other bands. Some I already had in the works, whatever. So that's kind of how that went the first however many years of the band. But since we've been a two-piece, it's like we've revived some old shit. And I'm all about doing weird shit.
Yeah.
So I'm like, this is going to sound crazy, but try this.
Uh-huh.
He's like, you're nuts. I'm like, I know. He's like, oh, that sounds good. So, like, this record's got a few weird songs where it's like, what the fuck's going to happen the next second? And they're only 2-minute songs.
Oh, well.
Nice.
Nice.
Yeah.
I mean, isn't that punk rock,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Like, that's the way to do it, to get in and get out.
And there's six different parts.
Yeah.
In 2 minutes.
Okay, of the 13, how many are experimental? How many are like straightforward, right?
Half and half.
Half and half.
Yeah.
Six and a half.
Yeah. One's half experimental.
Half of one song half goes insane.
Yeah, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Sorry, I'm an accountant.
Yeah.
So some of these are old ideas. How many are brand new ideas?
So on this record, we've got, I think we got 4 brand new songs.
Okay.
2 of them that weren't finished before we went in the studio, and we said, roll the dice.
That's right.
And they were finished in the studio, which ended up being my 2 favorite songs on the record.
Well, it's like the freshest material, too.
Because
then you can like look back and be like, fuck yeah.
Yeah.
You didn't have time to like get over it.
Well, there's pressure.
Right?
Yeah. There's pressure, and then you come up with your best shit.
Right, totally.
Yeah. So.
But you also just don't go back to what you did and change it, right? So one of the coolest things about writing in the moment is that you're going to just accept what you wrote versus like second guess it, try to rewrite it. Like it's got to what comes natural. That's what I like about on the spot shit is like you just get forced to just produce something and like just what do I feel here?
Yeah.
Instead of like what's going to sound good? All right, maybe if I go to here.
Yeah,
like,
no.
Not just let the instinct
take. Yeah, gotta let the instinct take because you only got.
And this a lot much time. Of like when we start writing a song and we've been working on it too long, I say we're playing it in the next set.
Oh, that helps. Yeah,
right.
And that's what's great about the Dollhead.
Get it out.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
That's what's great about the Dollhead is there's not always a lot of people there.
Everything.
Ooh.
GoPros. Everything. Oh, is that solid?
Yeah.
I think that might be the winner. Yeah, it's
Nick's winning right now.
Yeah, I think that takes.
Doing good today.
So that's what's great about the Dollhead for us is.
It's practice.
We take a lot of Thursdays
practice
there.
Yeah.
And so we're at practice already, and then we go to the Hut, and there's 4 or 5 people there, and 3 of those 5 people are people that have come to see every show. So we can play those songs at the Hut.
That aren't finished. And,
and you can get, like, real-time feedback.
Yeah.
And like I record everything we do almost on GoPro and you know, all
sweet.
That kind of stuff
so
we can
good.
Go watch it back later and
like that's that
good.
Went well and that was a good idea or something like but you can't
I hate this part. Let me rewind.
Yep.
I hate this part.
God, I can't believe
and
I did this.
And we do the same thing at practice too. we record a lot of our practices when we're working on new stuff.
But we don't always we don't progress very well always. Like
no, we don't.
That's so
true. That is true.
Oh, I just
we have to throw ourselves into the fire to get a song to where it needs to be. Like we've got a lot of ideas. We have a
we have a whole whiteboard in our lockout
of song titles that we need to
that
write.
We come up with
titles but no songs.
Titles but no songs.
Yeah,
because we don't have lyrics,
so
we don't have to write lyrics of the song titles. So we can just make the songs. Title
like
whatever
that.
The fuck we want to say.
And so you pick a title, like, what does that sound like? Like this.
Like, we're going to write this one next, and then we take it to the other board.
Yeah.
Exactly. I like this.
It graduates.
System.
Yeah, it graduates.
It graduates from the concept board to the set list board.
To the we're trying on it.
Yeah.
That's great.
I like that.
And
a
like,
lot.
even when we became a two piece, we've rearranged almost every single song that we had when we were a four piece or a three piece.
Is that right?
To work as a two-piece.
Yeah.
Really?
Because we don't have a vocalist anymore.
Yeah.
We gotta keep it interesting.
We gotta fill some of that space, that vocalist space that we had to
leave.
With
moves, changes, dynamics. Yeah. Okay.
So, like, not every single song has been touched in some way.
Right.
Especially the ones we wrote before.
Well, you gotta retrofit it, right?
Exactly.
Yeah. You gotta make it your own.
Exactly.
Yeah. Fantastic. All right. Do you have a favorite song on the new record? And is it related, or do you have a favorite title? Are those the same song, or those different
songs? And do you have
a
name for the album?
Ooh, that too.
Year of the Radical is the name of the album.
The Year of the Radical is the name of the album.
Yes. Fits very well.
Exactly.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
Great.
That's
great.
It.
Great.
Mm-hmm.
I have a personal favorite. Mm.
Have you even discussed this amongst yourselves?
I don't know what your favorite is. I don't really care.
Yeah, it doesn't. Nor should you.
You
played
good on every song. So.
What's your favorite?
Cell Service. So if you write it down, so it's Cell Service Ice Cream.
No, it's the name of the song is Cell Serve Ice Scream.
Ah.
Yes. But if you write it down, it's
Cell Service Ice Scream.
Yeah. Cell Service Scream. Because the cell service, because we go live on our phones from
balls.
Our place.
Of course.
And the building is built out of cinder blocks.
Fuck
so the cell service.
Are you a Gemini?
Like, Gemini? Sound like Gemini.
No, my wife is.
No.
No, Gemini. It's an OC rehearsal space.
Gemini
no,
rehearsal
we're at the Electric
no,
Jungle.
No. Electric Jungle is the place where.
But no fucking reception?
Yeah.
There's no reception. So the cell service makes us scream.
Yeah.
So we kind of combined self-service ice cream and cell service scream.
And self-service ice cream.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's
so if you write the name of the song out, it's cell service scream.
Yeah.
But if you if you capitalize the I in service, it's cell Serve ice scream.
So then, do you have caps and lowercase?
Yes.
For the, okay.
Yeah, we will. We
good,
will.
Good,
yeah.
Good.
No,
like
it's my favorite.
It's
agreed. Gnarly. I got to use my sitar pedal. That was fun.
Ooh,
sweet.
Oh, that's fun. Ooh, yeah. Effects pedals. Like, what are pedals are you using?
Well,
I mean, the JCM 100s are doing like a big, giant noise for you.
Yeah, I mean, I try to keep it as clean as possible.
It makes a loud noise.
Yeah, it go boom boom.
It sounds like fucking rock and roll. Yeah. Yeah, that's what it does.
But I mean, I have my distortion pedal is an EQ.
Oh.
Boss EQ.
Oh, great! And you just kick
the big old boost.
Like,
the boost, yeah.
Those mids to get the extra out of the amp.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Dope.
And it sounds
for
great.
For effects.
Yeah.
Holy Grail.
Mm-hmm.
Course 2. The Ravi Shankar.
The sitar.
Sitar pedal.
Nice.
Yeah. That one's finally utilized in
that
the song.
That thing's sweet.
And the,
the
what is it, MDX? The delay?
Yeah. The clone,
the
carbon copy, right?
Yeah, carbon copy. Yeah. That's it.
That sitar pedal we got for this album specifically.
For that song specifically.
Yeah, for that song.
Nice.
I'm like, the song, we worked on that song for almost a year.
Oh, shit.
Sweet.
I'm like, it's missing. I don't know what's missing. Something needs to be funky in it. And we can't come up with anything else that's really, like,
What made you think sitar?
It rhymes with a guitar.
Ah.
Sitar, guitar.
Means less guitar.
Checks out.
And more sitar.
Checks out.
Well, Antoshi has the sitar guitar.
He offered...
Oh, yeah, I've seen those. Do with
he
the
offered if I could play it on the record, and I... He's like, but it doesn't work in the higher frequencies. It's like,
no, it.
Yeah. The what's
pedal,
the point?
The pedal was better.
The pedal worked out.
The pedal worked out.
Well, and I also got to stand in the fucking in the room.
In the amp room.
In the amp closet.
Room. Yeah.
Yes.
For the feedback and all
like,
the other fun things.
Good luck in there. Like,
cool. She didn't wear earplugs in there either.
Well, well, you know, you gotta face it.
Well, I had the headphones on.
Okay.
Yeah. That'll kill some of the high frequencies. That's what you want to get rid of is the.
But I'm really happy how that song turned out.
Agreed.
On the record. It's
agreed.
I think it's gonna be the opening track. It's got a lot of things going on.
Cool.
It's slow. It's got some grunge things going on. It's got some jazz shit going on. It's got some fucking metal shit going on. It's got a lot of things going on.
Did you do a lot of production on it, or is it just like guitar, drums? No claps.
Guitar,
no.
I did a couple overtops.
No rain
like,
stick.
I didn't.
Not this.
I didn't get the clap on this one.
Right.
But
yeah. You never know. Like I mean.
I did. Yeah. They might not have heard it, but I was singing in the closet.
It might show up like really low in there somewhere.
Holy fuck!
Easter egg.
I gotta imagine working with that producer was great, like easy to work with, like
the best.
Oh my
just
God.
Went from thing to thing, seamless.
Yes,
I mean
13 songs in 3 days is no small feat.
Between the two of us being super starstruck and very nervous because we're like, shit, somebody just offers a record deal. Like we should get on it. Like,
we should probably take this seriously.
Yeah,
we better
kill
this. Yeah, exactly.
Like, and we didn't have all the songs ready. So
we
like,
we did not.
We pulled it together.
We finished/finalized probably at least 3 or 4 songs in the studio.
I redid them.
Yeah.
You weren't there for that.
I redid your drums.
I had him set up your drums on day 3.
Were you comping while you went? Like comping your tracks, or was it just one?
Are they all live takes? Or
They're live takes, but I mean everything's got a double guitar on it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, we for the drums we did live takes.
Right. That's what I was asking.
She did. More or less scratch guitar, and I played the drums along, and we used
almost
at
all
least
of them.
most of the scratch guitar tracks we used, and then we did kind of, she went back and did another
layered
day
a little bit,
of layers,
but it's not,
and, but mostly what you hear, mostly what you hear is all live.
Sweet.
Cool.
Yeah.
Killer.
It's what we sound like live.
Yeah. That's
what you want.
And that's exactly what we were going for. We're like, look, we don't need to
overproduce it.
Yeah. We don't want to overproduce it. We don't want to have anything on the album that like we can't at least mostly reproduce in a live show.
Yeah. Totally.
Makes sense. So. Especially as a 2-piece. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
People are going to be weirded out.
You want to fucking rock and roll rock.
We loved your album. What the fuck?
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, yeah. Where's all the sound?
What the fuck is this?
I don't see a singer or a bass player.
Yeah. And that's exactly it.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. Did you listen to the record?
We specifically did not record bass because that's not what we are.
Yeah.
But we recorded most of the guitar. A lot of the guitar that we kept was shit that was she was playing out of her AB switch out of a bass amp.
Right.
Yeah. When we were recording.
Because that's how we play live.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So that's exactly how we play live.
You get them thick tones.
Yeah.
So there was no bass guitar recording. It's all low end out of the AB switch out of a bass amp that we kept because that's how we sound live.
Yeah. The one time we went to tape, a producer took us to was that Black Rebel?
Yeah.
Took us to tape, and it was just, let's get exactly what you guys sound like live, and then let's listen to the song. Okay.
Do it one more time.
let's do it one more time.
Yeah.
Okay, let's bounce out the tape. It needs sleigh bells. Let me get in there.
Yeah.
Oh, they...
Okay, it's done.
Yeah.
And that's it. And that was the whole thing.
Yeah. They spectered that shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sleigh bells. Just, that's it. Like, I'm a producer.
Oh, it's played by the producer.
Okay, great. Yeah. All right.
I want sleigh bells.
You really changed the song there.
Yeah.
But yeah, he was just.
I think he also mixed them down too after he. Yeah, like, he heard his like.
Oh, 100%.
But ultimately, it was like plug in and get it.
Yeah.
Our next record is gonna be that because this one was the way over the top,
was
overproduced,
the over
reamping fucking keyboards, intros, outros, all that shit.
Yeah, and the growing pains of having a new studio. That
you got to do it that way.
Yeah, there's like
we
shit
have to take
where
this thing through all the paces.
Yeah, we reamped my bass, and then after we got done, we're reamping the guitars. And we're like, this sounds like shit. And then we're like, oh, we need a reamp box.
Might have been nice.
We're sending out some terrible signal.
Yeah. No wonder
we're
why
sending out
all
line
your bass tones were crazy.
No.
All right.
It's a trip. I mean, like, I've recorded analog before. And thankfully, I don't hear that much of a difference.
Yeah.
Because
and there's
really
enough fucking
expensive
to make your digital recording sound analog if you want.
Yeah, exactly.
To.
Yeah.
Thing is, on Spotify, coming out of my iPhone.
Doesn't matter.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
YouTube doesn't matter.
Yeah,
exactly.
You guys are playing soon. You're playing at Alex's bar.
Yep, next
week. Next week.
Yeah. Ooh. I think he's.
I might be able to come to that one. Is that Saturday?
It's a Thursday.
I'm free because my compadre here is on vacation.
Yeah, you're getting to Montana.
There's gonna be a DJ. There's gonna be a country act ish.
Yeah,
and
shout out Pluto.
So it's gonna be a.
So we're gonna just gonna destroy the place.
I hope it's the country act that I'm thinking of because last time I was at Alex's bar and I saw the country act.
No, it's probably not. But yeah,
okay.
They used to be a rock band.
They were fucking fantastic.
Yeah,
okay.
I got really sad because we had them.
Pluto's gonna be great,
and we have like songs that we as a band like sing parts of their song.
I know. Love
and
it.
We love Pluto.
We did like the 3-part harmonies for them when they're here. Like, oh guys, we don't play that song anymore. I've been singing this for like 4 fucking years.
Can we cover it?
Yeah.
Ooh, we should. We should cover
Dude,
it.
Dude, it we would
have that
sounds like
we
fair
would
game.
Destroy their shit.
Oh, it does sound like fair game.
That would be really fun.
Dude, that would be hilarious.
We have a 60 to 90 minute, they say. So.
Yeah. I know, yeah, we have a long set. Because we're the only two bands.
Yeah.
All right, we have a wrap up question that we like for people. What is the first album you bought with your own money?
This is embarrassing.
No, there's no such thing.
I think Britney Spears was my first one, so don't feel
bad. Mine is Backstreet Boys and Blink 182. Yeah.
Honestly,
the first
album I bought with my own money was the one and only Boxcar Racer.
Feels so mad.
That's a really good album.
Young and Hopeless.
Yeah. Sometimes.
Yeah.
Really good record. That's the first one I remember buying with my own music.
There you go.
My own money, rather, was the Boxcar Racer.
Powerful shit.
Good record.
Yeah.
Good record.
Sorry, dude.
No problem, dude. If you want to count Columbia House,
yes,
it was my penny. It was my mom's penny. No, I will leave that out because that doesn't count because I got a lot of albums.
But did
at
you
one time.
Own it? Like, was it yours? Did you listen to it?
Yeah, but I got a lot at one time. Remember, you get 12 for one.
Yeah.
I bought 2 albums at once.
Yes.
Yeah.
I bought Collective Soul. Their first album.
That's embarrassing.
All Things Left Unsaid.
All Things Left Unsaid.
Red with the guy. Yeah. Great fucking
it's good
record.
Album.
Yeah.
And Salt and Pepper, Very Necessary.
Yeah. I mean, dude, also a good fucking
great
record.
Great fucking record.
That's a good one. Like,
it's really good.
Yeah.
Really
great spectrum, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm pretty well-rounded.
Yeah. First show you guys saw?
Oh, yeah, first concert. Yeah, first concert.
My first concert was Huey Lewis in the News.
Yes.
For sure.
Fuck yeah, of course.
Yes.
And how old were you?
What?
Single digits.
Okay.
Nice. Yeah.
Oh,
that one that I was talking about earlier at the San Diego County Fair.
Oh, when your brother was being a bitch?
I was maybe 7 or 8 years old, maybe. And that was the first live show I remember going to was Huey Lewis in the News. Yeah.
Cheap Trick.
Oh!
Age 4.
That's epic.
Minnesota State Fair.
Minnesota.
Epic. That's so good.
Yeah.
Of course.
Yeah, what a good fucking...
If that's
I
what
was
you're
like,
supposed...
oh.
This is what people are supposed to do.
Yeah. I'm walking crouch forward from now on.
Of course. Oh.
Yeah.
Where the bitch is at? Oh shit, I don't have a guitar. Wait.
Let me get a guitar. Okay, where the bitch is at? Here's my crotch. Well,
ladies.
Where's my
5-neck
guitar at?
Jesus Christ. Oh. Yeah.
Would you double neck? Have you double necked yet?
I haven't double necked.
It's almost time, right?
I don't really know.
Next record. You've gotten to sitar pedal now. No, it's good.
All right, all right.
Maybe it's the
maybe
triple.
You need to come over. We need to have a conference.
But just imagine 12 strings, you know?
Yeah.
It's a lot more. I can barely handle the six.
Well, they're very close together. They're very close together.
I like the split V one.
Oh yeah!
Oh, the split V is bitching.
Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah, because you see, like people are like, I'm gonna play this song, and they're like playing both bass and treble.
Okay, I have a final question, and then ender question. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But the final question is, who would you tour with right now? That's touring. Like, who would you ideally go out with right
who
now?
Want to tour with? Who will you?
Outside of everything, dream world.
Yeah.
Oh man.
Yeah, outside of everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pink Floyd. Who gives a shit? Like,
I wouldn't tour with them right now.
Right.
Yeah.
I don't like
Honestly, who we should tour with is Whiskey Dick.
Because
they're in Europe. They're going to Europe.
I don't know if
that's the right answer, but...
There is no right answer. I was going to say Film Speed.
Oh.
Why are we touring? We go to Arizona sometimes.
Yeah.
Sounds hot.
It is hot. It is hot. It's pretty hot.
Okay, I think the end of the question,
that would be fantastic. I love the yeah-yeahs.
They're on the road right now.
Yeah.
I know they are.
Yeah.
I think I got COVID at the IAS show.
That's a song title right there.
I was going to say, that's a song title.
Or a t-shirt.
Fairly certain I did.
I went to see the IAS and all I got was this COVID.
And two t-shirts.
Allegedly.
I don't know. I don't think we're like anybody else, so I'm a... I like a lot of bands. I'm kind of a music whore, so I don't.
Then ideally.
Ideally.
Aerosmith.
Only if they have opiates.
You know they do.
Yeah.
It's not good years.
You know they do.
Have you seen them? How else are they?
Faya. I'm gonna say Faya.
Okay. Oh wow. Hell yeah! Solid. That's a good choice.
There you go. Fuck yeah.
That's a good choice.
That is my final answer.
Okay.
Fuck yeah.
So next year, Europe with Thea.
That'd be pretty awesome.
Right, okay, right.
That would be rad as hell.
I'm down.
Okay, end your question is, what song do you want to play at the end of the episode? Any song could be yours.
Probably.
I'd recommend it.
Yeah, probably should be yours.
Could be anyone's.
But we put other people's music on here. We don't care about copyright.
Yeah, we don't make money off this, so.
Yeah, yeah.
Doesn't matter.
Well, I would say play Fever or Meow.
Or Mia, off
the Yellow EP. Our album that came out after that, the By Injection, we mostly re-recorded on the new album, so we're kind of not doing that.
All right,
fantastic.
Fever, listen to Fever.
Let's
play
it.
Fever, because that's the one that's also got a music video on YouTube.
It does have a music video. Consistently.